Now, Gambia High School is a leading school in the school country, not only in Gambia, but in West Africa. It's one of the best schools in West Africa. Now, we want to maintain that status. If we get assistance from the alumni association by uplifting the school.
I am really happy to hear that this is being created. At least somebody is thinking of the others coming up. And I wish you all well. And I hope you will succeed in this and we will be able to do something really constructive.
If you look at the aims and objectives of the Alumni Association, it's in line with our education policy. We cannot talk of quality without a conducive learning atmosphere. And this is one of the primary things that the Alumni Association is thinking of.
For Alumni Society, it's a very good thing because Gambia is a school that nobody supports. Because you go out there and with the name of Gambia High, they'll tell you, no, the president do everything for you. That's what Gambians think, that whatever we need, the president is doing it for us, forgetting that we're not the only school in the Gambia. So the ex-student coming back to the school to help is a good thing. As everybody can see, the school need real renovation, and there are lots of things, as the principal rightly said, there are lots of things we need as science students. We're missing a lot. Most of our tests and exams is done by a test of practical. We don't do it, the practical itself.
There are very important people in Gambia now that went through Gambia High School. So we can invite them to talk to them and say, we have been through here, we have been here, we have been like you, we have been pupils like you. And they will look up to those people.
For what we are looking for, that is every student have a mentor. Your mentor know your family background and see how best to help you with the Alumni Association. Therefore, I think if this is done by the Alumni Association, I think there will be no student in Gambia Senior Secondary School who will not graduate with flying colors and have what as the others what they have in Europe, America, and all other parts of the world. So those were the words that I wanted to send to the Alumni Association.
We want you people, the Alumni Association, to help us to improve the teaching and learning of science by providing us scientific apparatus. It's not only enough to see them on diagrams in books, but the practical aspect of handling apparatus is also very, very, very important in the teaching and learning of science.
Just like what the principal has said, we have so many challenges. The toilets, the staff room is not as big as it should be. Furnitures, otherwise also, the staff room, we don't have furnitures for teachers to sit. The toilet is in dire need for repairs. The classrooms also need to be repaired because the floor, the tiles are all broken up. The labs need to be uplifted, the biology, chemistry, physics, even the home economic science and the agri science lab. They need to be uplifted. And even the hall. If you look at the semesters, these are all condemned internationally. So we need to replace them. And to uplift the hall also is not in a very good shape.
Concerning infrastructure and so, it discourages many students because I chat with a lot of other students in different schools. When you talk, the first thing they will tell you is Gambia High is not secured. So I am one idle student. I need a school that is secured that I can stay in class. The fact that it's not secured, the school is too large and there are lots of outlets where students can move in and out, that a prefect who should also be in class cannot control that. Administration alone cannot control that. The position of the school make it so difficult to be controlled that the school need to be secured in the sense that lots of outlets has to be closed so that the school should have only one gate or the school be separate from the field so that the Banjulians who don't have any other work to do but to disturb if they come, they can be in the field and we be in our school.
But we are learning blindly. What I mean by blindly is we are learning based on test of practicals. We are not able to go on with any experiment. We cannot go on with any experiment because we don't know how to go on with it, because we don't have the required materials. So these required materials, I think they are the ones that we need as of now. And also the school itself, the location of the school is very good. But those who were here since 1959 up to date, 1959, they can see how the school was. That's almost the same way the school is. So I think the school should be fully renovated in order for other students to be able to come to this particular school. Gambia Senior Secondary School is not a school where people nowadays people think like it's a school that doesn't learn, because they see the outlets everywhere. People will not even want to bring their students now to Gambia Senior Secondary School.
I think the society coming up to help renovate the school and secure the school proper, I'm just giving this out. If I were to be asked, what do you want us to do for the school? I'll first say, separate the school from the field so that the school can be a little bit smaller so they can be easy to control. The students can be retained inside. But this big school and lots of outlets, you cannot control it singly.
Right at the moment now, we have lot of problems. Infrastructurally, the school was built in 1959. Number one is the size of the library. It's the same, still the same library since 1959. Then we were almost about, when I was looking at the statistics, it was almost about 450 students. But today we are talking of 2,200 students with a teaching staff of 60, ancillary staff of 27.
There are people who have been students of the school as way back as 1959. To mention a few, Lawyer Surahata Jane, it's my cousin, is a student. Gabi Sose, quite a number of, James George, quite a number of them who are all ex-students. They're in their fine, well, old age, but still, by way of knowledge, by way of expertise, by way of advice, by way of counseling, there's a lot they can do. And I'll make sure, as chair of the association, that I reach out to those people out here in the Gambia to see what we can do collectively. We should not leave it just to the younger ones. Okay, they have been the driving force in the formation of the association. But I want to call on all and sundry, young and old, to come and be members of the association. Membership is very simple. You just have to be a past student of the school, or you can be a friend of the school, you can be a well-wisher of the school, you can be a parent of the ex-students, you know. So it's really open, and they can come, all of them can come and join the association and be members. Membership drive is on right now, right, both here and abroad.
On behalf of my board and on behalf of my Parent Teachers Association, to thank the ex-students who took up this initiative to help us to boost the quality of education in this school. We are very, very, very grateful.